Let's also get into the interview, or I guess the TASBot segment we got going on. I am joined now by the one, the only, the ever talented, ever more intelligent than me, dwangoAC. How you doing, man?
I'm not so sure about that last one. You're pretty smart there, my friend.
Okay, thank you.
Well, let me...
my brains is not the reason why they hired me.
Well, then
it was my looks.
I'll help you educate yourself.
Yeah, of course. So, tell me. Like, maybe a little smarter about Majora's Mask. What are we about to see here?
What you're about to see is a little bit of demonstration of how a tool-assisted speedrun is kind of made in one sense, because I'm going to be showing you a little bit of the controls. In this case, I've mapped them to an 8-bit dopad just to kind of demonstrate. But we're also going to break down one of the glitches a little bit. It's a two-frame weird shot. And we're going to compare that against a one-frame weird shot, because that matters. And they're a frame apart, and I'm going to show you the differences and what can happen if you mess it up. So a lot of things that a real-time runner does, especially in a game like this, can be very frame-specific, where you have to hit a narrow window. Now, in fairness, the N64 is not exactly known for the highest frame rate.
Didn't have a ton of 60 FPS games, but still we're talking here, you know, for the 3D Zeldas, a lot of times dealing with that 20 frames per second. So a frame perfect trick, still only about a 20th of a second you're getting to work with.
And that's not exactly a lot when you're moving at full speed. I'm going to demonstrate this at slow motion with frame advance using the Dolphin emulator. Really quick setup information. This laptop here is a System 76 laptop running Linux natively. This is the Dolphin emulator running on it, and I just have a controller that I've mapped buttons to. So we can get that up on screen. I'll show you the emulator here. This is running Majora's Mask, and I have this handy little button that I've mapped right here. It's right here. I can press this shoulder button and advance one frame at a time. So I can make the game run even slower than it normally does. Now, at any time, I can press this button over here that I've mapped to the load state button, which means I can back up at any point to an earlier state, and we'll be using that a few times. So I'm going to show you in real time what this glitch looks like. I'm going to try to annotate. He's going to set a bomb, pull out his sword. I'm sorry. I couldn't do it. See, it went too fast. How about we try that again? So I'm going to load that state again. Okay. Let's load that again. So he's going to pull out a bomb, get his shield, get the bow out at the same time, hold left and down at the same time as the bomb releases, and it shoves him through the wall. So we're actually on the other side of the wall right now. One more time with feeling. So we see this wall right in front of Link. It's going to go right through. We just clipped him right there. So you can see those plants there. Now, what I'm going to do next is kind of break that down just a little bit more. There's actually a ton to unpack here. The bomb set here. I'm pressing this frame advance button so you can kind of see what's going on. It's really tiny, but if you look on the right-hand side of the screen, you can actually see on the screen what player one is pressing. So right about here, okay, we've now pressed Y and L, and we're holding left and down on the analog stick. Right here, you see the bomb start to explode. Right there, it's a little bit more exploded. And right here, you can see he released Y and released all of the buttons. When I say he, I specifically mean, I can't remember his name.
Oh, Majin Phil we got coming up right here.
We had Majin Phil, but it was another member of his community helped me out, and I can't remember his gamer name. I really apologize for that. Helped me make this replay file.
Well, shout outs to that person, wherever you are.
Aaron, I think. I am so sorry for him forgetting his name. So he helped me make this. One of the things that he did here, when he did this two-frame wrong shot. I just said it wrong.
Weirdshot, I believe.
Wrong shot is...
They were starting to run out of names in the N64 Zelda community. They were like, Weirdshot, sure.
Yes, sure.
And it stuck.
It stuck. So this one demonstrates going through the wall. But what I'm going to do is a little bit funky. So I'm going to load a state here right here. This state is odd because it's at a place where the game renders the frame purple. If I go forward a little bit farther, you see our friend where the bomb has just exploded. If we move forward, we go through the wall like you've seen me do a few times now. So from this point, I'm going to do something different. I'm going to go back to that point, but I'm going to set the game in a read-write mode. This means it's now recording what button presses I'm making here. So when I load this state, it says switch to recording. So I loaded that save state I just made. Switch to recording mode. Now when I frame advance, it's no longer pressing all of those buttons at the same time. We'll still see that purple effect, but we're not holding the buttons down anymore. Instead of a two-frame weird shot, we get a one-frame weird shot. If I advance forward, you'll see that instead of going through that wall, which you can see over there, we're just going to keep going down the elevator. all the way down. And at this point, I can actually move around. I can show you. There's the platform we were on earlier. There's the bushes.
That's where we wanted to be.
Well, maybe. I don't know. It depends. So I'm going to load that. Let's switch to playback. All right. So this puts us all the way back here. So now if I go back here, we can see that compared to the two shot again. So this is where they want to go. They want to go through the wall here. If you mess up by one frame, you end up in the basement or in the lake or the water, whatever you want to call it. It might not be what you actually wanted to do. That might really mess up your route. There's going to be a lot of those types of tricks in the run you're about to see. And this is a good way to find out what the game mechanics are. And it also demonstrates exactly the amount of skill that some of these runners have to pull off repeatedly over the course of a what-hour run? 5 hours?
5 hours of intense gameplay we got going on here with this Majora's Mask 100% run. I've asked a lot of people in the 3D Zelda community over the years, and I've had a lot of people tell me they think Majora's Mask is actually the hardest 3D Zelda speedrun. There's so much stuff like that. You're one frame off, and all of a sudden, your route is completely messed up, like you're saying. You're ending up in a basement instead of being able to get to that mini fairy right there. So awesome demonstration right there, Dwango.